And we go directly now to Britannia Secondary School, where Jim Iker is now addressing the media on behalf of the BCTF.
Thank you. I appreciate
it. Yeah, and I want to honor our members who are
behind me. I hear you did a
behind me.
Flyer.
Yeah, so that's coming out tonight.
Jim,
here we go.
Can I start off here? What's it going to take to get back to the bargaining table? That's what a lot of parents and their kids want to know.
Okay, and I'm going to start with our members.
Yeah, how are you willing to let this go, Mr. Iker?
Well, first of all, it's great to be here with standing strong with our members here at Britannia, proud members of the BC Teachers Federation, and taking the stand for our students, for a fair deal for teachers, and most importantly, better supports for our students.
So how long do you see this going? How long do you think your teachers can be on the line, and how long can students be out of class?
Well, our members are standing strong because they know that this is about our students' learning needs and getting better supports for our students into our schools. And our members are taking that stand. And you know, they are losing pay, and it is a financial hardship, and not getting strike pay. But they know the importance of this struggle for our students.
Do you see this going into October? Are we talking weeks?
Well, you know, we want to be back at the bargaining table. We want to be back at the bargaining table today. I understand government says that they want to be at the bargaining table, so what's preventing that from happening? So we can be there with Vince Reddy, or if he's, or we can be there just with BCPC right now. So that offer is open. Let's go. Let's get this deal done. We need some flexibility from government. We need some faith from government that they actually want to get a deal. You know, Mr. Fassbender is out there saying that we have to make more concessions. Well, what about government? It's time for government to start indicating that they'll move. It's time for government to actually start putting more funding so we can get a negotiated collective agreement that meets the needs of our students.
You have said that's the big issue here, class size and competition.
Yes.
Yet the government's chief negotiator, Peter Cameron, says the stumbling blocks are wages and benefits. That's, of course, the government side. But isn't that what this is about right now?
Actually, you know, that's what government is saying. But the number one issue right now is to address the learning needs of our students. If government were to take off E80 off the table, that could get some significant movement happening at a bargaining table. And we can hopefully wrap this deal up in a few days. You know, it was unfortunate that we couldn't get the deal on the weekend. It was obvious that government was not ready for full-scale mediation because they didn't put one single penny towards meeting the needs of our students. So let's deal with the class size, class composition, drop E80. We're not going to negotiate away our recent court decision or any future court decision. That's the expectation of this government. We need government to put funding in to deal with the learning needs of our students. That's critical in this.
Have you picked up the phone? Have they picked up the phone?
I phoned Mr. Cameron on Sunday to talk with him about getting back to the table, letting him know that we're ready and willing. Make another phone call today, and we got to get this moving. You know, we were ready all summer, and government only agreed to one day at the table on the 8th of August, and that was after 14 days of discussions, trying to get them to a table, trying to get them into mediation.
Just follow up on that. Would you agree to binding arbitration?
You know, arbitration is an option within the labor code, and it's an option along with mediation. It's an option that we can take a look at in terms of some of the issues that we have at the table. But I think what's really critical to get this bargain moving along is government dropping their demand to that we negotiate away our right to the recent court decision and any future court decision. You know, that's just not acceptable, because what we want to do is deal with the learning needs of our students. We need to have more funding put in by this government. They've offered no new resources, no new funding since we've been bargaining to deal with that issue. And, you know, it's so important that we start seeing smaller class sizes here for our students and more one-on-one attention through more specialist teachers working with our students one-on-one. That is so critical.
What about going back? Having the teachers go back while you enter into talks again? so the students can get back in class?
You know, we want to be back at work, but we want a negotiated deal. I mean, this is a government that could have been negotiating in the summer and refused. At the end of June, we spent 6 days trying to get them into mediation rather than actually being in mediation. This is a government that's violated the supreme law of the country, the Constitution, not once, but twice. They were found to be bargaining in bad faith with us. And now they say, trust us. We need the pressure to get the deal. We need more pressure on government. And obviously, this government just does not seem to care.
So are you willing to compromise on class size and composition, or is it only the 2001 levels, the 2001 language that you would accept?
What we want and what we're willing to do, and that's why we are asking government to drop E80, let the court run its course. We won a huge victory in January, where the Supreme Court of British Columbia ruled that this government violated the constitutional rights, the constitutional charter. And they said that the legislation that they brought in 2002 was null and void, which restored our provisions of guarantees for our students of smaller class sizes, class composition guarantees, and more specialist teachers in our system that can work one-on-one. That's an issue. So we know there's an appeal. We're okay with the appeal.
Minister Fath.
If the courts rule again in our favor, what we're saying is, government, it's time to honor a court ruling, give the school districts the necessary funding to put the provisions back in place that will give the guarantees for our students.
So you will only go back to that pending the appeal, basically? Like, there's no, is there room for negotiation around that right now, or are you
looking for? Oh, well, what we want to negotiate is, okay, we're saying let the courts decide. Government, drop E80. The expectation that we're going to negotiate away our court decision and future court decision. So let's let that process continue. In the meanwhile, on an interim process, what we need is additional funding into our schools. And that's why we've put that fund of $225 million on the table. Let's negotiate. Government has not actually put a counteroffer. Government has not put in any additional money towards resolving that issue. What they have is the Learning Improvement Fund, which is already there. It's the same money. It hasn't dealt with the needs of our students. So let's negotiate that fund. It's an interim basis. Let's get an agreement on it, and let school districts and our local teachers union decide best on how that money will be put to use in terms of whether it's classroom teachers to reduce class size, or is it the hiring of specialist teachers so there'll be more, you know, teacher librarian, teacher counselor, learning assistance teacher that can work either one-on-one with students or in small group instruction. That's where we're asking. We could have done that this weekend, and government did not put one penny towards that.
Jim, can you be legislated back to work without prejudicing the appeal case, or no?
Well, you know, I'm hoping we're not going to be legislated back. The minister's been clear that they're not going to legislate them. And part of the problem over the years is government continues to legislate, which bails them out of actually coming to a table and negotiating a fair deal with us.
But is that a viable option in light of the preceding court case? I mean, my understanding, or I'm at least told, that it may have some impact if they legislate you back to work.
Well, it's definitely going to have impact for sure, because this is a government that's legislated us more than twice, and two of the times they legislated us, it was a violation of the Constitution. And what they did was illegal. So I'm sure government is thinking about that, but legislation is not the answer. We don't want legislation. We need more funding put to this bargaining table to get a negotiated deal that addresses the learning needs of our students.
Are you going to go back to your members this weekend to gauge appetite for continued strike action, or no?
You know, we're a very democratic organization. Our members have voted twice now, and our executive continually monitors the situation. We have decision-making bodies that monitor the situation. And, you know, what's important right now, there's pressure, we need more pressure on government. And for us to relieve all pressure on government, that's not going to get us a deal.
How far apart are the two sides exactly from the government's over $300 million?
Well, you know, that actually works out to approximately $3 a day per student over 5 years. And what we need is government to actually commit some new funding to address the learning needs of our students. And I don't understand why they don't believe we need to have more money to address the issues of class size, class composition, and specialist levels. You know, we're close on wages, 1% apart, 1 year term. You know, that's not the issue. The issue is class size, class composition, specialist levels, meeting the needs of our students so we can give that one-on-one time. And I can't reiterate that more. And government's not willing to move. Drop E80. Let's get back on track. Let's get to the bargaining table and let's work hard to get a deal.
Are you? Both sides are close on wages, but yesterday the minister and Peter Clark are saying that the BCTF is asking for double what any other public sector need has gotten past the committee.
Well, you know, that's what they're saying, but they're not coming to a bargaining table to negotiate in a fair way where they're going to show flexibility. So let's talk about it at the bargaining table. Let's deal with the issues of class size. Put more resources into the system so we can better support the learning needs of our students. You know, talk with the teachers here at Britannia about the needs of the students in this school. And what's not happening, what's missing because of the underfunding. You know, we have to remember $1,000 less per student than the Canadian average. That's huge in terms of resources, funding, support that our students are not getting. And it's time to address that. Government's own Standing Committee on Finance back in February stated that this government, their government, who is mostly Liberal MLA, said that they need to put more money into K-12, that they need to address two issues in particular. One is being the whole issues of support for students with special needs, class composition. And they also said that government must at least give school districts the necessary funding to cover downloaded costs which government creates, like BC Hydro rates, medical service premiums, rates, insurance rates, heating rates, and so two recommendations that this government has basically ignored.
As this goes unresolved, are you worried about losing the support of the public in this dispute?
Well, we want this dispute resolved, and we have the support of parents. And we, you know, we don't want to be out on the line. We would rather be in our schools today with a negotiated deal, knowing that we have the support of more resources so that we could start meeting the needs of our students. You know, what we have on the table, you know, won't even come near as much as there should be in terms of the extra funding that's needed, the extra teachers that are needed to work with students. And that's what's so important, and that's what this government seems to not care about or to ignore.
Is the government trying to break your union?
You know, there you go. Words there from BCTF President Jim Iker, hearing from both sides this morning, Jody, as we strive to reach a resolution. And I think the big loser in this situation is the public school system. As parents, teachers, government, hoping everybody would be back in schools today. This discussion is going to continue, getting your feedback on social media as well. No easy solution, but hopefully we can reach one sometime soon.